Hey guys and girls, welcome back to another edition of Spintires. Now today we are going to look at a new map. Now this new map is called the Everglades. It is by Risky Whiskey, and I got it from Spintires.nl. Now the thing is that on the notes for this map it says it's a wet map. So I'm going to need some trucks that are pretty good at dealing with mud and muck. If you haven't figured it out yet, I'm a big fan of mud maps, swamp maps. I love water, love mud. I'm not into the rocks and hill climbs as much as I am into going through into deep water and river crossings. So I'm gonna bring in my favorite map exploration vehicle at this point in time, which is CCSV Knowles Chevy 3500 HD. And just in case that one gets bobbed, I'm gonna have to bring in something that's pretty capable of pulling it out. So the only other vehicle I use, believe it or not, is also another CCSV Null 1's vehicles, is the Ford F450 Dueling. So let's get into the game. Now I haven't been on the map before, so floating truck, that's interesting. Let's do a quick changeover to get that truck back on the ground. And there we go. Okay, so let's change back again. So change across to the Chevy. No, change to the Chevy. Thank you. Okay, so we've got a garage up here, and the rest of it is covered in cloak. Oh, there's a second garage there. There's a lumber mill there. There's a lumber mill there. There's fuel. There's an objective there and an objective there. So two objectives. Oh, and a log kiosk in case you feel smart and have enough dexterity to load your logs up yourself. You can do that too. Okay, now it is a wet map. And what that means is there is a lot of water. You can see there, lot of water. Not so much rivers, but more like bog holes. So you need vehicles that are capable of dealing with mud. So let's take CCSV Null 1's vehicle out, Chevy out to explore this trail over here. I'm going to give it diff lock and all-wheel drive straight off the get-go. We've got 199 litres of fuel. That should get us somewhere. Now, this truck is actually really good at mud. If you're in another truck, you probably will slow down an awful lot. So don't think that this mud's shallow. It's just this truck is good at handling mud. So, as I said, whatever truck you choose may not be as quick as this one is. Because this mud can slow vehicles down a lot. Alright, so let's follow this. Oh! Cloaking point! How do I get to it? Maybe I'll drive this way. Let's see. We'll go around here. So it's a relatively flat map. It's not hilly or anything like that, but that does not mean it's not a challenge. Can we go across here? Okay. I don't know. I'm guessing. Where'd the cloak point go? Oh, it's over there. Looks like there's a sunken tree log or something there. Oh, tree. Oh, no. Look at the mud. That is some truck-killing mud right here. Okay. Oh, whoa. Oh, jeez. Okay. I think I just bogged it. No, I'm still moving. It's all good. Yeah, I'm just winging this. Just winging it. Yeah, I think I bogged it. I bogged it. How the hell am I going to get it out? Move backwards. This is nuts! That makes getting to that cloaking point just that little bit more of a challenge. In fact, I think I'm going to say screw the cloaking point and you guys can figure out how to get there on your own. Ah! Oh, you're kidding me! Come on, Chevy. You need to get out of here. This is bad. This is really bad. Okay, we need to get out of here. Yeah, you guys can figure out how to get to that clicking point on your own. I'm not going to do it. That would mean this is a very short video. Because I think if you got stuck in there, you would take maybe an hour or two just to get yourself back out. I mean, yeah, you could rescue yourself back to the garage, but you wouldn't have any fun. So, okay, we'll head back to the trail. And we'll just keep on exploring. Yeah, if you don't like mud and water, this is not the map for you. This would be quite a challenge doing with trailers, and you need a pretty competent 6x6 or a decent 4x4 with grunt to get you through it. Is that a trail in there? Huh, I can't tell. Alright, I'm gonna ignore that bot there for a second, and we'll just continue on this way. Ooh, fuel! Yay! Oh, tree roots. If you hit these too fast, you will get damaged, so be very, very careful. And we're through. Okay, let's top up with a bit of fuel. Okay, and we'll head off again. So it's not as if Risky Whiskey didn't put... Yike! As I said, if you hit those tree roots too fast, you will get damaged. So, the log kiosk, I'm going to assume, is... Oh, I don't know. Seems a bit weird having fuel here than having fuel over there, but anyway. Let's go this way. Probably back down the road we just came, but anyway. No, we're curving around to the back end of that cloak point, which if I'd have known before, would have been handy. Okay, okay. Can I get in through here? Just mow the... Oh, there's a tree. Come on. Work with me. Work with me. Work with me, not against me. Yay! We managed to get to that... Oh, phooey, there's a tree. Oh, come on, man. That's a tease. You get so far and they get stopped by a submerged tree. Let's try this one. Oh boy. Yay! Okay, that opened up that section of map. So you can see objective there, log kiosk there, more cloaking. You get hidden trucks. That's a type B, so... Okay. Interesting, interesting, interesting. What I might do is swap over to the Ford. And let's explore the other way. And of course, if it gets bogged, then I'll have to go and get the Chevy to come and get it out. So let's go this way. Whoa. As I said, this mud, it's mud, okay? It's going to slow your vehicle down. Even in a vehicle like this, which is pretty good. It's still going to get slowed down. And the trails aren't exactly smooth. As you can see, this thing is bouncing around. I love the turbo whine on this thing. Okay, so we come around here. Did we just go into gear 3? Oh, back to 2. Oh, this is slowing us down. Now, some of you are saying, dude, just put it in manual low and just nail it. I'm like, nah. I'll let the auto gearbox do the hard work for me. I'm lazy. Okay, so we'll come through here. Where does this road lead us? I've got no idea. Oh, boy. Come on. Get through it. Let's go. Move. Find grip. Let's go. Whoa. That's mud. Oh, tree root. How's that for a nasty hidden surprise? Oh boy. As I said, it's a wet map. I think this is fantastic. This truck's not doing too bad. I mean, I've driven trucks in the Beat the Snot Out of series that were worse in mud than this thing. So it's not doing too bad. It's getting a little deep. I'm a little concerned. Because this doesn't have the ultra high water level of the other trucks. It's about where it should be. And it doesn't have a snorkel. No snorkel. Come on. Oh, there's another fuel station just over there. Look at that. Just off screen. Wiggle it. Just a little bit. I wanna see you wiggle it. Come on. There we go. Oh, this is fun. It's a challenge. It's not as easy as it looks. Okay, there's a lumber yard just over there, I think. Whoa. So yeah, it's not as straightforward as it would seem. It's going to take you a while to do the logging on this one, mainly due to all the mud. So it will be fun. Alrighty guys, but anyway, that is just a brief sample of the Everglades map by Risky Whiskey. And as you will see, I haven't even uncloaked half of it yet. But anyway, guys, I hope you guys have enjoyed that little preview. Sorry it's taken a little longer than I thought, but there is a lot of mud. Alrighty, guys, until next time, I will catch you later. Bye for now.